love?
What is love?
Just love.
Yeah. You know, love it is...
It's an indescribable emotion.
Love is when you...
Oh, God. What is love?
I don't know.
I can add it back.
Hey, John Bartholomew Tucker here, trying not to be sad here today on our last show. So, did you hear about the fellow who tried one of those new banana facials for men? Yep, you guessed it. He slipped on his nose.
Still I can't get started with you. On the golf course, I'm under par. Metro Goldwyn have asked me to star. I've got a house, a show place. Still I can't get no place with you. Cause you're so supreme. Lyrics I write of you, I dream. Dream day and night of you. And I scheme just for the sight of you. Baby, what good does it do? I've been consulted by Franklin D. Greta Garbo has had me to tea. Still I'm broken hearted, 'cause I can't get started with you.
Go out and get a job, do something.
And so I ended up working at Macy's.
Selling cards and safes. And...
selling skis. I knew nothing about selling skis. Head skis were a big thing in those days, and it sounded as if I knew what I was doing. I walked in to have lunch, and when I say struck by, I was struck by mom. And I never forget, she was wearing a green sweater, reading an existential novel, Jean-Paul Sartre, and I did say, I walked over, and I've never done this before in anybody in my life, but I was struck, I was smitten, and I walked over, and I got over to her table, and she hadn't seen me yet, but she was reading, and I thought, I gotta say something, and so I said, excuse me, are you an actress?
And I said, yes.
is married, I would say
persistence.
Period.
You've got to have more than infatuation.
I would say that marriage is one of the highest forms of friendship that humans have. Hmm?
It's when they...
Marriage is the union of two human beings who want to forge a life together, possibly have children, and not go through life alone and have a best friend.
When they're together, right?
Yeah.
Right.
Marry me, marry me, marry me, marry me.
We were at Mount Utsianta, known as Mount Utsi. We're up there, and I'm driving down this dirt road from Mount Utsi, and I said, I don't know what I said.
I remember what you said.
What did I say?
I think I want to marry you. You sounded so surprised, darling. You did.
I am big pretender. I think I want to marry you.
I am big pretender. But the thing is, you looked so shocked, like you never expected those words to come out of your mouth. And when I met your mother, she said she never expected those words to come out of your mouth. Yeah. And I shocked myself by saying, yes, I think I do.
Howdy, pal.
Howdy, chick.
Art thou Tom, Dick, or Harry?
Call me Tom, Harry, or Dick.
I'm a maid.
Maid who would marry and would no longer tarry.
I'm a maid.
Maid who would marry. May my hopes not miscarry.
I'm a maid.
Maid mad to marry and will take double quick.
Any Tom, Dick, or Harry. Any Tom, Harry, or Dick.
Oscar Wilde said that, one of my favorite writers. He said, the basis for any long-lasting relationship, whether it be marriage or friendship, is conversation.
They never run out of things to talk about with each other.
You never run out of conversation. We can talk to each other for the next 50 years.
And that is so true.
We always enjoy talking with each other. Mom has a wonderful sense of humor.
He knew everything.
Dad fascinates me still.
They're best friends.
Love is very important, and love is the basis, but friendship is key.
And I think that they both agree that it's just very lucky, very fortunate that they found each other.
I always say to myself, I'm just lucky. Mm-hmm. I mean, I'm lucky. I married a person that I love and like, and that's just luck. I thought of him as an older minister, and he was probably 32 or something.
Uh-huh. Yeah.
And he said, well, let's see, you are both Lutheran, you go to this church, do you? I said, no, we don't go to this church. Oh, well, you're both Lutheran then. I remember he was trying his best. No, we're not. Oh, well, it's not as if one of you had been born a Catholic or something. I said, well, actually, I'm a baptized Catholic, but I haven't practiced. Oh, well, that's all right. Not as if anybody is partially Jewish or anything. I said, oh, well, anyway, let's talk about it. The poor guy realized now, he said, let's talk about the wedding. So we were married in the church.
And, and present, the only people there were my family, my mother, my father, Pooh, Betty, Tante Betty, and Lila.
Ima and Dorothy.
Well, Ima and Dorothy, Ima and Dorothy. Somehow, I must have been nerves. I started giggling during while he's, you know, and do you draw?
Ima wouldn't have banged her, she thought we were crying.
Well, but then I turned around and I see Ima and Nina doubled over laughing.
Yeah. Yeah.
And they were laughing so hard that I got hysterical laughing. And I was trying not to laugh, and the tears were rolling down, and the minister thought I was crying with emotion.
If the minister had had enough, you know, now he's got two people who are laughing, you know.
And then he said, "You kneel." Remember, we were supposed to kneel on these pillows, and I didn't know what he was talking about. I had never kneeled, you know, the only time I thought you kneeled was in a Catholic church. Mm-hmm. So that sent me over the edge. I almost got hysterical trying to hold back the laughter. Even my mother was smiling at that point. And so then we He said, you might not pronounce your man or what.
Moment with really Omi fun. And Grams was staying at their house over Christmas.
Christmases come to mind big yeah. time.
Paradise for a child on
Christmases. Well, just before Christmas when everybody's decorating the tree.
The Christmases.
And when everything is set, then your father puts on this record, and I wish I remember the name, but we love the tune.
I've never had Christmases like that my entire life.
And when he does that, then he looks at your mom, and your mom lights up, Evie lights up, and you see there's something, and I've noticed it year after year after year after year.
And I cherish seeing them, seeing their excitement, just their joy. It's a treasure.
It's one of the moments of true happiness, I think.
And I had, as a little girl, these two beautiful cousins in glamorous Berlin. And I came and visited as a little girl from the provinces. And here were these two little princesses living with my glamorous uncle and aunt in a magnificent apartment in Berlin, and they had beautiful clothes, and they ate marvelous food, and they had a little vacation house by a lake with a swimming pool, and it was just too wonderful for words. And there I just adored the two little girls. This was Ema and Evie.
But oddly enough, one memory that I very strongly have that nobody knows except Evie and John and I is for the brief period of time I lived with them in Springfield, Massachusetts when I was a child after my mother died. Mm-hmm. And I remember living with them in the house on Watershops Pond, and how it took me out ice skating, and it was the first I'd ever ice skated on this huge, beautiful pond, mm-hmm. and sledding there. And I remember Evie working very hard, as I seem to remember, very hard for a long time on a Halloween costume for me or something. I don't even remember how that turned out, but it didn't matter. I just remember her putting great efforts or thoughts into it. And just being there with them at a time in my life where my whole life had collapsed because my mother had just died. And, mm-hmm. and spending that time with them, first in Binghamton, I remember, and then in Springfield, really stabilized my life. It really gave me a grounding again at a time when I really needed it. And that was, I actually lived with them, so it was a very intense and very close time with them. Yeah. So I'm always grateful for that time. I think it really got me centered again after the great trauma.
You will woefully wonder why, my dear, through your cataracts and catarrh, you could squander away or sequester a drop of a precious year. For when your best days are yester, the rester twice as dear.
Myself, I'm the luckiest guy in the world. I met Mom. Without Mom, there wouldn't be any family. I wouldn't have a son, two daughters, grandchildren, three, four grandchildren. I wouldn't have any of that. So the family means everything to me. And for future generations, you're very lucky to belong in a family. Mm-hmm. And it's a wonderful thing. The family.
That's my answer too, because I came from this very small family, yeah. And as a result, I'm not very social, as you know. I'm kind of reclusive, but to me, family is everything. Family is everything.
Yeah. I always envied people who say the family is everything, and I thought, yeah, well, my family is. It doesn't. My dad died when I was 16. It was my mother, and that was it. Mm-hmm. And now I can say the family is everything because we're a family.
Yeah. Yeah.
And what's your favorite flavor of ice cream?
All these. If you're going to get into hard questions.
Yeah.
Well, that's it, guys. I got 10 seconds left, so I'm just going to
stop. Oh, perfect time. Yeah.
Goodbye.
The hours I've spent feeling broken and bent and unwell, but there's still no cure so heaven sent as the chance to raise some hell. Everybody, oh, it's time to start living. Time to take a little from the world we're given. Time to take time, or spring will turn to fall in just no time at all. Now when the drearies do attack and a siege of the sads begin, I throw these regal shoulders back and lift these noble chins. Give me a man who is handsome and strong, someone who's stalwart and steady. Give me a night that's romantic and long, and give me a month to get ready. Now I could waylay some aging roué and persuade him to play in some cranny, but it's hard to believe I'm being led astray by a man who calls me granny.
Oh, it's time to start living. Time to take a little from the world we're given.
Time to take time, for spring will turn to fall in just no time at all. Now sage is sweet, the day just sweet, good deeds and good work earn you laurels. Never have told, maybe you'll understand why. I believe if I refuse to grow old, I can stay young till I die. Now I've known the fears of 66 years, I've had troubles and tears by the score.